Hello everyone. Myself, Mr. F.R. Sayed. I work as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. The topic for my today's lecture is for loop. That is for loop in C programming language. At the end of the session, the students will be able to explain the basic working principle of the for loop and then apply the for loop for a given problem statement. Now, the topics to be covered in this lecture are, first of all, we'll be dealing with introduction to loops. Then we'll go to the types of loops, and then we'll see the syntax of the for loop, followed by a sample program, and at the end, an assignment for the students based upon the programming concepts. Okay, now let us first see introduction to loops. Generally, in a C program, the statements are executed in a sequential manner, meaning the first statement inside a function is executed first, which is then followed by the second statement, and so on. However, in some situations, a block of code may need to be executed more than once, that is, several number of times. So this may involve repeating some portion of the program either a specified number of times or until a particular condition is satisfied. Now such situations may require the use of a loop control instruction. Now let us first see the loop's flowchart that explains what is a loop, how does a loop work. Now let us suppose the control of program execution comes to the point where the loop is going to start. So there we are going to check the condition. If the condition turns out to be true, then the code will be executed. That is, the code inside the loop will be executed. Here we have termed it as a conditional code. And this goes on continuing. If the condition turns out to be false, then the loop is terminated and the statement after the loop is executed. Now let us see the types of loops in C language. In C language, we have three different types of loops being used. First one is the for loop, second one is the while loop, and third one is the do while loop. Now basically we'll be seeing the for loop first. Now talking about the for loop, it is the most popular looping instruction being used by programmers. It is widely used. Now it allows the programmer to specify three things about a loop. The first one is the initialization part, where it allows us to specify the initial value for the loop counter. Second is checking whether the loop has been executed for a desired number of times. Now this section is called as conditional checking. And then we have the third part, where incrementing or decrementing the value of the loop counter every time after the statements in the loop have been executed. Now this section is called as iteration section. So after every execution of the loop, by what value should the loop counter be incremented or decremented is specified in the iteration part. Now next we have the general form of the for statement. Now inside the for loop, as shown in the slide, we have three sections. The first one is the initialization section, terminated by the semicolon. Then we have the condition section, then the semicolon, and then we have the iteration part. and then followed by the curly braces within which the block of statements is written. Now let us first try to understand how does this loop work. Now the initialization part occurs once. After that, the control is transferred to the condition part, where the condition is checked, and if it is true, the statements inside the loop will be executed, and after executing the last statement in the loop, the control then transfers to the iteration part, and after iteration, once again the control is transferred to the condition part, and if the condition still holds true, then the control is once again transferred to the statements inside the loop, and this process then continues. Hence, the looping statement works in this manner. Now let us see a sample program to know the working of for loop, or using the for loop, how can we perform a task of displaying the multiples of the number 5. Now basically in a C program, we first of all have the first line displaying the inclusion of header files. That is, the first line is hash include stdio.h. This is standard input output header file. Then we have the declaration of the main function, followed by the opening curly braces of the main function. Then we have declaration of an integer variable I. Now this I variable would be used as a loop counter. Now inside the for loop, we have these three sections. Of course, the first section I equal to 1 is the initialization part. Then we have I less than equal to 10. This is the condition part, and then I equal to I plus 1 is the iteration part. The other way to write down this is I plus plus. Then we have the opening of the loop. It includes only one statement, printf 5 multiplied by percentage d equal to percentage d. The first percentage d would be replaced by the value of I, and second percentage d would be replaced by the value of 5 into I. So basically, we want the output as 5 into 1 equal to 5, 5 into 2 equal to 10, 5 into 3 equal to 15, and so on. Now this process goes on continuing as long as the value of I is less than equal to 10. And every time the value of I is incremented by 1, and once again the condition is checked and the looping statements would be executed. So this is how the for loop works. And this indicates the end of the loop. And then of course at the end we have the return statement, and this concludes the main function. Now the students are expected to think and write the answer to the following question. Now write a C program to display even numbers between 0 to 20. Now students are expected to make use of a for loop and answer this question. So now pause the video and write your answer. Okay, so now we have the answer to the question being asked. The question was C program to display even numbers between 0 to 20. Now as we know, what is an even number? A number that is divisible by 2 is an even number. So we have written a code for that. The first line being inclusion of the header file stdio.h. Then starting of the main function, then declaration of a variable I, which will work as a loop counter in this case, and then the for loop for I equal to 0, I less than equal to 20, I equal to I plus 2. Of course, this is initialization, condition, and iteration part. So what will happen when the value of I is equal to 0? The condition is checked, 0 is less than equal to 20, it's true, and then this line is printed, that is percentage d value of I, that means 0 is printed. After that, in iteration part, I value is incremented to 2, then condition is checked, and then value of 2 is displayed. So this part goes on continuing, and it terminates when this condition fails. So that means we have as an output for this program values of 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, and 20. And thus this concludes the program with the return statement. Now these are the references used for the video lecture. The Let Us See book of 13th edition by Yashwant P. Kanitkar, and the website of www.tutorialspoint.com/cprogramming. Thank you.